diagnosed with bipolar and ADHD at the age of 6.
Well, I grew up in a group home. I grew up in children's homes. I was never with my parents. My mom chose the drug life. I never knew my dad. And from 14 all the way up to I was 18, I was in a child care. From different homes, different group homes, foster homes. It took a long time for me to forgive my mom, though. Because I could never understand why she chose that life instead of helping raise us. Well, I actually wanted a different scenery. Just start over, something new. And we looked it up online, and they said that there's a lot of places that they'll help me out here.
So when we came out here, we didn't have nowhere to go. We slept in the tent. And then I was like, just go to the GR building. I ended up getting directly on GR. He had to wait 15 days. So they put me at the wine garden, but he slept right outside in the tent that we had got. I was very scared at first because I was not used to none of this. On around like 6 months to a year after I started adapting. And I was like, okay, all these people out here, is this normal? But when I came out, when we first came, all this stuff that you see out here now, it was not out here. Most of these people that live in these tents don't really want to pay rent. They don't want the responsibility. But I look at it like, why keep all that money when it's they actually giving it to you for you to get on your feet? You know? Like where I stay at the Harrah, but I didn't know that I'm still considered homeless. Just staying there because I don't have my own bathroom and kitchen. Do I like it down here? No. I would rather go to Beverly Hills or something, Hollywood. Because I feel like out here, it's a lot of negativity out here. If I go out there, you guarantee to meet somebody that's willing to help you, sincerely help you. Do I like going to Panhandle just to make money for us to eat with? I hate that. But I know if I don't do it, we won't have nothing to eat. Some people say, why don't you get a job? I have seizures, and they come about anytime. If I get overheated, I work myself too much, that'll send me into a seizure. You know, my body temperature get overheated, I'll go into a seizure. So right now, I'm a liability to most of the companies out here because they don't want to take that chance. So if she's having a seizure while she's tending to a customer, what is that going to say to them? Me being down here and being with mental health, all they do, I don't think they really into helping folks. Like they say, they just want to go to mom, say they pray, to give them a prescription, and send them on about their day. That's not helping nobody. Filling them up on medication does not always solve the problem. You know, it's probably something more. I feel like me taking that medicine, it doesn't help the issue. It suppresses the issue because when the medicine gone, I'm still feeling the same way. And I feel like it didn't do nothing for make me into a zombie, sleep, and when I did get up, I felt the same way. How do I feel? Like crap? You feel like committing suicide? Yeah, but I'm not going to tell you that so you can drug me up even more. But now what I found out what they do is when they facilities get overcrowded, like really, really meant to help people that's gone, that'll kill you in the quickness. When they stop in the degrees, they come. Bring them right down here. So now we're in amongst of thieves, killers, psychos. Sometimes I had to sleep with dudes just to have, you know, have sex with people just for me to have somewhere to sleep at night. I'm out here, I didn't have to do that. I refuse to go back to that. Why keep degrading myself just for a good night's sleep? I got tired of doing that stuff. It's like I know there's something better to this life than what I'm living right now. So I said, I know God got a purpose for me. I don't know when or where it's going to come, but I know there's a purpose out here for me somewhere.
I have gone out to possess witch, haunting the black air, braver at night, dreaming evil. I have done my hitch over the plain houses. Light by light, lonely thing, 12-fingered, out of mind. A woman like that is not a woman, quite. I have been her kind. I have found the warm caves in the woods, filled them with skillets, carvings, shells, closets, silks, innumerable goods. Fixed the suppers for the worms and the elves, whining, rearranging the disalarmed. A woman like that is misunderstood. I have been her kind. I have ridden in your cart, driver, waved my nude arms at villages going by, learning the last bright roots, survivor, where your flames still bite my thigh, and my ribs crack where your wheels wind. A woman like that is not ashamed to die. I have been her kind. I have been